Hello and welcome to the Mean Boys Podcast. Every boner brings us a little bit closer to death.
I'm Keith Carey.
I'm Connor McSpadden.
And I'm
a divorced ninja turtle. There is something about the board shorts and the thousand-yard dead-eyed stare that really combine into a very specific look.
Yeah, that's fair. I also didn't realize I was dressed all in red when I rolled up.
You also look like your enemy is a giant rat.
Yeah. Or your only friend. Mother boss. Yeah, you came up in all red. Your car made a sound that sounded like if a car could also be a ghost. Like, yeah. Your car just naturally made enough noise that Jordan went, did he just crash into the curb?
Yeah, the answer is not today.
I've used this joke on other people before, but you did look like Jonestown Kool-Aid Man. Like,
yeah, no, I did.
Burst through the wall. Choose death.
The red on red. I don't know why I chose to wear a hoodie because it's not cold.
We're going to fight a bull after this. Well, so you had to be ready.
Yeah. Well,
Tom was wearing red on red, so he looked like the world's only surfer Crip. With his like sandal thongs and his fucking board shorts.
Fucking beach day for the Bloods.
Eastside bra.
I'm not a huge Ninja Turtle fan, but it always seemed like a huge waste to me that they didn't have like an enemy game of the gang of tortoises that were samurais instead of ninjas. Like they did nothing
really good.
They did nothing with tortoises in the whole thing. I mean, it's got to be the natural counterpart or foe of the turtle.
What of the tortoise?
Yes, indeed.
I love the idea of one Ninja Turtles writer just beating this drum really hard at every meeting. And they're like, Steve, can't you just draw like a machine gun on a pig or something? And he's like, we're not fucking leaving.
Yeah, they're like, dude, Shredder still sells toys. So how about you work on some Shredder stories, yeah. Dave?
Would you shred up some ideas?
I mean, the tortoises could have been like the suburban Ninja Turtles. Tortoises in general are like slower and they age more. They're not.
Oh, now I'm understanding where they're not in the cartoon. It's a bunch of tortoises reading books and listening to NPR, eating pesto with their wives.
Fucking nerds.
Well, yeah, it also makes sense. Turtles are in the sewer because they swim. They don't swim.
Tortoises are stuck in the liberal shell, man.
Of all the goofy bits for you to be able to fact check and well, actually, this absolutely is A1.
Oh, yeah,
it was designed for your zoo books knowledge.
A lot of tortoises live a lot longer than turtles, though.
You just know these things. That's what's so great.
But more turtles taste good, apparently. I've never eaten one.
I've never eaten a tortoise. I think I ate turtle at some point.
Eating a tortoise or a turtle feels unsportsmanlike.
Well, you don't just pick like it up
raping
live
a guy
and
with
suck
no
it
legs.
Out like a...
What is he going to do?
You don't suck it out like an oyster. Like,
but you still kill it with a stick when it's fucking walking at 0.8 miles an hour.
It's not all that different than killing a cow. They're equally dumb.
Yeah.
Well, tortoises know how to move. They just do it very slow.
Okay.
Cows will just kind of stare at you as
cows
you shoot them
can
the
kick
head.
You. You know, they got some defense mechanisms available to them. But a tortoise, I mean, against a human, it's totally fucked.
Right.
Like, if my move is I can just pick you up and take you to some boiling water.
Yeah. I can basically put your house into fire.
Yeah, exactly. I can evict you from both your soul and the place you live.
So, when I lived in Vegas, I was obsessed with desert tortoises. And they can live to, like, I think, like, something crazy, like 150 or 200 years old. You have to get, like, a special permit to get one as a pet. One of the things I learned is you can't even pick them up at any age because they'll pee and not drink water and die of dehydration.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
So they're not even like...
There's a kid in my neighborhood who'd do the same thing. If you picked him up, he'd just start peeing and he'd never drink and cry to his mom.
Yeah.
Much like a tortoise, he was also kind of slow.
Yeah. So, yeah, if you want to kill a desert tortoise, you just got to, like, hold him.
That's good for codependent people who never want their pets to die.
Yeah, yeah.
Imagine your tortoise at your funeral in a little suit.
There was a lady who was like a deacon at my church when I was growing up who had a fucking tortoise that lived in her bathtub. Like a fucking big one. I don't know any specifics about desert or lightning type or whatever tortoise it was. I just know it was a fucking super tortoise. And like somebody brought up like, they live forever. And then we were all doing the math on like, this lady's like 70. She's going to die before the tortoise does. And then we were like, she lives alone. Is that tortoise going to eat this old lady from our church? Because I don't know if a tortoise will eat a dead lady.
Unless she's made of lettuce, I feel like no.
Yeah, they have very specific diets.
Okay.
Yeah.
They really do sound like liberal suburban.
Is this dead body gluten-free?
Yeah. Is this lady a cactus? Because if not, then I don't think it'll eat her.
I like to pretend I have celiac disease.
Yeah.
Well, it's episode two, boys. Do you think we should actually say what we're doing here?
Yeah, we spent weeks coming up with like the plan for like, all right, exactly what we're gonna do with the relaunch and like how we're gonna roll it out.
None of it.
Well, yeah, because what happened is we got the mics on and then we turned it into fucking virgins on prom night. We were just like, oh my god, comedy, and we just fucking nutted way too fast. We
totally forgot to do any business.
Yeah, we did no housekeeping foreplay. So yeah, first of all, thank you to everybody who like got super stoked about the show coming back.
Seriously, I was blown away by the response. It was like too crazy. You guys really made my day.
Yeah. Look, we are very self-deprecating here, but I genuinely thought we were going to relaunch. Like, I was bracing for maybe 10 people to care.
Yeah, but we had 12, and that meant a lot to us.
No, but you guys have all been so fucking awesome. It's cool to see how many of you are somehow still alive. And what we're doing is we're doing 10 episodes. That's the plan currently.
Yeah, we're locked in for 10. Anything after that is in the breeze, but we're committing to 10. And we've got a live show as part of that 10. That's going to be at the Third Wheel in Hollywood, October 20th at 8 o'clock. Halloween, you wanted it, you got it.
Yeah, it's happening.
I saw someone's already looking at flights from Canada, so I appreciate people making ill-advised life decisions to come see.
I get the emails from who buys tickets, and somebody who lives in Alaska has already purchased tickets. So.
Wow.
Either we made $20 and have two empty seats, or somebody's about to make another dumb decision on behalf of this dumb show.
God damn, that's the power of Pine Sol, baby.
And I've had a couple people ask me who's going to be on Halloween. We don't know yet. I will say this, though. I don't know if you guys saw that I posted this in the Discord. I put a Facebook status up announcing the show was coming back, and Steve Ranazzisi commented on it.
But he was already here for 9/11.
I want to try and get Steve to do Halloween. Like I
would love
no
that.
Promises to anybody, but I am going to ask him.
And we might be able. I'm not sure we'll be able to get him these days, but we might possibly be able to get Ramsey Badawi.
Oh, I've gotten way more comments about Ramsey than I did about Steve. No one has asked for any of our famous guests back.
No.
The 9/11 guy and Ramsey, and that's it.
They want a boutique experience.
Somewhere Steve is listening, he's like, I had 9 seasons of a fucking TV show. I'm one of your famous guests.
But that's
guests.
Not what we brought you on for.
What's funny is I went backwards. I love that every episode is going to start with us talking about Steve now.
We love Steve.
I went backwards where I just knew him from the 9/11 thing and like stand-up, and then I started watching The League after all that shit happened. I'm like, oh, this show's actually good.
It's a funny show. It's just a joke dense show about fucking scumbags. What could we have in common?
And I think we all can all agree it's what Steve will be remembered for the rest of his life.
Yeah.
I think that's all the house, unless there's any housekeeping shit that we missed.
Make sure you send us your questions at meanboyspodcast@gmail.com or on Twitter or Instagram at meanboyspodcast, and leave us a voicemail at 804-818-6326. That's 804-818-MEAN.
Yeah, and a shitload of you got the message on that, because we have a lot of way more voicemails than I expected. Yeah.
I realized that we acted as kind of like a BetterHelp type service for lonely truck drivers that needed to kind of vent about their transgender niece.
I saw somebody comment in the thing. They're like, well, I was going to go to therapy since not a show ended, but now Mean Boys is back, so I can push that off for a little longer.
Hell yeah. We're happy to delay your growth.
Methadone for growing up.
Yeah. Yeah, it is fun that so many of you came out. Also, it's not Twitter and Instagram anymore. It's X and Threads.
What? No, Instagram is
still Instagram.
I saw you signed up for Threads.
I signed up like the second day. I just didn't post until the other day, and then I saw a bunch of notifications through shared accounts we have. Tom posted for the first time on Threads. I did a show that night, and my friend Kazim was like, oh, wow. Threads made sure to tell me it was your first time posting on Threads today. Threads is so excited for you to be had on their platform.
Threads is like, 2 weeks later, somebody remembers we did this.
Yeah, I think feel like Threads is going the way of Google Plus. There was a lot of excitement that turned into a whole lot of nothing.
Yeah, it's I don't know. I'm done with change.
Okay, that's enough of these. That's enough of our hot Threads takes. Yeah. Let's get into the Mexican joke off.
Ay, so topical.
I'll take us away this week.
Do it.
5 women clogged a toilet at a Florida restaurant, then fist fought the employees. The arresting officer said, "Much like that toilet, I'm not going to take this shit anymore." Florida, you gotta love them. I've learned that the reason there's so many crazy Florida stories is that they have looser laws about what they can report of like happening. Yeah. So just the more ground level like goofy crimes just get into the press.
Right.
And God bless it for monologue joke writers.
I love that story because what I think happened is girls are so weird about pooping and ever being perceived as people who poop. So I think they took a shit and they're like, all right, we need to draw focus from the big shit we took. And they orchestrated the fight.
Just start a riot.
Yeah. So January 6th happened too, actually.
Actually, in a similar mindset, a woman set fire to an Orange County Target to create a distraction to steal baby formula. In other news, Keith's mom's parenting book is being read and understood.
What to demolish when you're expecting.
Yeah, I thought that was like such a great news story that the person was like, I know, I'll cause $500,000 of damage so I can steal, I don't know, $80 in baby formula.
How bad are you at shoplifting that you need this much of a fucking smokescreen?
Yeah, she obviously didn't read Keith's mom's book because Keith's mom got away with it.
Yeah, that's true.
My mom has the first book that came out in paperback and in Kindle and on the wall of a truck stop bathroom, which is pretty impressive.
It's called What to Steal When Someone Stole Your Pussy.
Yeah. She's the John Grisham of places you suck dick for $9. All right, I got one. The crew of a passenger ship pushed a man to his death. Now, we make a lot of jokes here on Meme Boys, but there is nothing funny about this man who was drowned by fairy semen. Nothing funny about the fact that an overwhelming amount of fairy semen caused him to take fluid into his lungs.
Nope. That's a sad day for America, everybody.
Yeah, you're a bad person if you thought that was kind of funny.
All right, gang. Wild radioactive pigs are wreaking havoc in Germany, which is weird because Keith and Tom are right here.
I am become death. Porkenheimer.
Porkenheimer's pretty great.
Bhagavad Gita.
Just one guy in Nagasaki just looking up. That's all, folks.
A dog escaped and roamed around the Atlanta airport for 3 weeks. TSA never stopped the dog because it was never holding more than 3 ounces of fluid.
Amazingly, I have a dog airline story showdown.
Oh, okay.
A different story, though.
This is one of the animal facts that Tom knows is the size of a dog's bladder. Yes. Stop here.
I already did that joke. A couple filed a complaint after spending a 13-hour flight next to a drooling, farting dog. The FAA apologized and confirmed the dog has been euthanized by an Air Bud Marshal.
There's nothing in the rule book that says I can't kill this dog in this airplane.
No, there's like a few that... Oh, never mind, I guess.
I still think about when me and you did Alaska, and we flew out in first class, we came back, and there was a dog sitting in our seats on the way back.
It was pretty indicative of how we did at the fest.
Yeah.
You've been bumped by a dog.
Yeah.
I one time sat next to Mario Lopez on a Southwest flight coming back from this music festival I was writing for.
Oh, hell yeah.
And I was sitting in between. I copped the middle seat quick, and they took the bulkhead, too. And I was sitting between him and his daughter. And I realized very quickly that I was texting about sitting next to Mario Lopez and his daughter, and Mario Lopez's daughter was texting about me texting about her. And I just see her like some loser next to me. He's fucking
excited about dad.
It's my turn?
Yeah.
Kanye West is being sued by his project manager for asking him to build a, quote, unsafe bat cave. Kanye told him, relax, it's not even as unsafe as the bat cave between Kim's legs. No, it actually sounded sick. He's like, I want a house where there's no stairs. You just go in through ramps, and there's going to be no candles, and there would only be generators in there. And the guy's like, the generators will fill the apartment with gas and kill you. And he's like, do it.
I love the idea, because you refer to it as an unsafe bat cave. I like the idea that they're like, well, Kanye, we looked at your plans, and we've got a model for a safe bat cave. Hang on. Writes on.
I want these emergency exits out. I want these fire poles in.
The irony if somebody became a Nazi and then gassed themselves to death.
The guy apparently thought he was building an art project, and then he was like, whoa, you want to live in this?
I thought this was a bit.
You know your divorce is going bad when you're acting out through architecture.
Yeah.
Ooh, yeah. Police stopped a Nebraska man who had a bull riding the front seat of his car. When he was pulled over, he explained, this happens all the time. It was just my wife. A good old my wife joke.
He then pushed the button that made his bow tie.
Exactly. All right. Oh, it's Keith.
Yeah, it's me. A man beat up his ex-girlfriend after she sent a text mocking his penis. The woman is recovering and released a statement saying, "Oh, now this tiny dick motherfucker knows how to beat the pussy up." She then added,
tiny dicks have probably caused more crime than poverty in Ronald Reagan.
Yeah, if you get so mad about somebody insulting your dick that you need to hit a woman, you better kill her, because if she lives, you're still going to have a small dick, and she's going to tell even more people.
Well, everybody now knows this is the tiny dick guy.
Yeah, because now I know, and I didn't know about your dick before.
If he ever wants to get a job again, he's got to have a really awkward 20-minute conversation about, I was the tiny dick guy. That was a long time ago in my life. I've grown a lot as a person, although my dick has remained the same size.
Nobody cares about him hitting a woman, but they're really concerned about the dick size.
I don't know if this Ross Dress for Less can have a small dick security guard.
Yeah, everyone has hiring problems. Process the same way the NFL does. Yeah, you can hit a lady just as long as you got a big dick.
Walmart's not really in the man clit.
No, I'd be like, tell us about this felony. What happened? Well,
small penis.
All right, gang. A town was flooded with 2.2 million liters of wine when a distillery leaked. Finally, white girls know the somewhere where it's wine o'clock. It's wine o'clock there.
I've been thinking about making my own wine.
Okay. Out of what? In what?
I remember when you made your own cold brew out of literal trash, and it was fucking delicious. It was some of the best coffee I've ever had in my life.
Old Tom's edible compost heap.
Tom had like two carved up jugs and a paper towel tube and like some saran wrap, and he was making this like super distilled dank potion. So if you want to make your own wine, I support it.
You were like doing to coffee what Kevin Costner does to his own urine at the beginning of Waterworld.
Well, what I really want to do is make my own whiskey, but the distillation process is really dangerous. So I figure I'd start with wine, which anyone can make wine, then beer, then work up to whiskey.
Don't you have to have a big pressure cooker thing? Like that's why those stills blow up.
Yeah. Well, you got to have decent. Yeah, you got to know what you're doing, which according to Google. Here's the thing. In America, they're like, oh, it's super dangerous. But everyone in Europe was like, we do this all the time. You just have to you have to pay attention. But like,
it's like nuclear power. They're like, why don't you just put the toxic waste someplace where there's no kids playing?
One guy did it wrong. So now no more for anybody.
Yeah.
There's an excellent A&E reality show called Moonshiners that was just about the last remaining Hicks making moonshine and trying to evade the police. And if you're really looking to kind of turn your brain off on a Pawn Stars level, high quality.
That sounds pretty well. Are you going to make it in the toilet like a prison? Or
no. No.
Don't ask like it's a crazy question. Like,
no, I'm going to make it.
You're not going to follow this up with, no, I'll make it at my vineyard. Like,
no, you can buy a, what's it, not the mash, the that's beer.
I think it's mash, isn't it? Sour mash?
I believe it's made of grapes.
Yeah, no, it's made of grapes. But you can get, especially this time of year, you can get like 10 pounds of grape wine or wine grapes for like $1. And then you just got to like stomp on them a bunch. You just got to kick the grapes until they give up.
And then just Tom stepping on grapes in a Little Caesars box.
Tom, what have you been up to? I'm thinking about turning fruit into shoes.
Yeah.
God, if we could bottle and sell Tom Goss brand wine, I think
there
it would be the biggest.
There already is Tom Goss wine. It's just a different Tom Goss.
Wait, what? Well, there's a third Tom Goss?
There's a bunch of them. One's there's one in NorCal. I don't know his deal, but he makes wine because it's Tom Goss. The name on the wine is Tom Goss. Occasionally people send me photos of it. There's the gay country singer. There's like an orchestra director dude in like Australia. There's a politician. All of them pretty conservative, which is interesting.
Even the gay guy?
No, I don't know his deal. I meant the politician is very conservative.
I would love to have the first Tom Goss conference where you guys we had a meeting of minds.
Being Tom Gossovich
welcome to the G12
shoulder
summit.
Shoulder pants.
Like, no, you talking to the wine guy, like, you're in the food business. Let me tell you about an idea I've got, the Cone Zone.
I love that all of you have the name and not one other goddamn thing in common.
Yeah, that kind of what it seems like whenever I look it up. I think there's another Tom Goss doing comedy now, too, in, like, Oklahoma or some shit.
Well, we got to kill him. Like, that can't...
Yeah, that can't abide.
Yeah. Well, only if he gets funnier than me.
Nah, we got to kill the him, then. you're up, bud.
Oh, it is me. Good. The Coast Guard arrests a man for trying to run a giant inflatable hamster wheel across the Atlantic. In other news, I need to stop drinking near the ocean.
Implying you were in the hamster wheel?
Yeah, it sounds like something I'd do.
You know, I actually had a story. The Coast Guard arrested a man for trying to run a floating hamster wheel across the Atlantic Ocean. The arresting officer said, Mr. Goss, you have to podcast with me at once.
Oh, shit. I'm bummed I don't have one now. Let's do
I'm
this.
Glad we both thought of you.
Yeah.
A man died trying to hike the entire Grand Canyon in one day. On the plus side, at least the family saved on not having to dig a grave. Just roll them right in there.
Oh, that's good.
World's biggest grave.
Yeah.
All right. Taking us home. 75 crocodiles escaped from a breeding farm during a Chinese flood. 75 alligators is also the pussy you get for doing jihad in alligator heaven.
I'm a croc bar.
Yeah, 75 crocodile. Virgins.
Osama been chomping.
All right.
Look at all this untouched alligator pussy.
All right, guys. We'll see you in alligator heaven right after this.
Wait, we got more jokes.
Oh, we
you
do?
Went first.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, sorry.
Yeah. She's like, fuck both of you.
Yeah, no.
You dare follow alligator pussy?
Just trying to make a clean throw to break, fellas.
No, we should have interrupted you better. But I was just like, this is a smooth segue.
A Florida police officer got fired for pulling a gun on a swimmer at a public pool for no reason. His commanding officer explained, he should have known not to do that. We don't pull guns on people who know how to swim.
Oh, shit.
Ooh, Tommy Goss. Nice.
Don't throw to the sketch yet. I got a hate crime to commit. All right. Ex-NFL player Adam Pac-Man Jones was arrested this week. Dozens of journalists snapped photos of the athlete in handcuffs as Pac-Man did his perp waka 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 waka.
Nice.
Fucking stupid.
All nice.
Right. Now the Mexican joke off is over.
Now we'll see you in alligator heaven.
This is not as good of a transition as the first one.
Hi, I'm Garth Benghazi, owner of Punisher Skulls, Punisher Skulls, Punisher Skulls. America's number one wholesaler of shit with a Punisher skull on it.
Punisher Skulls.
If you're a regular American, you believe two things. Transgenders want to eat your kids, and anything without a Punisher skull on it sucks shit. That's why I opened Punisher Skulls, Punisher Skulls, Punisher Skulls. We believe the Punisher skull is a powerful symbol, a statement to the world that says, my dick doesn't work and it's Mexico's fault.
Boo, Mexico.
We got everything. Punisher skull hoodies, Punisher skull t-shirts, Punisher skull MAGA hats. That's the kind of stupid bullshit you idiots love. Get yourself a set of Punisher skull truck nuts and remind everyone on the road which part of a cop you'd let bounce off your fucking forehead.
Lick that boot.
We even got Punisher skull baby onesies. Let the world know this is my American son who will one day grow up to hit his wife and die in a war.
These Punisher skulls don't run.
Every piece can be fully customized. The world's coolest skull and God's worst fucking fonts. Two great tastes that concealed carry together.
Comic Sans.
Label your hat. Commemorate your nephew who OD'd on fentanyl. Do whatever you want. I don't give a shit. This weekend's our biggest sale of the year. The Punisher Skulls, Punisher Skulls, Punisher Skulls Get Off My Lawn Extravaganza. The first 100 customers through the door get a meet and greet with that guy who choked that other guy on the subway. If you spend $500, we'll take you around back and let you deep throat a Marine. Or maybe he's in the Coast Guard. I don't remember. Who cares? Fuck you. Open up, you stupid little pig.
Swallowed valor.
Bring the whole family. We got minions for the kids. Don't worry. They're not the woke ones from Universal Studios. They're the weird ones from the Facebook memes who always talk about how America was better when we were dropping nukes and not letting Asians vote. We've even got custom Punisher comics. We've replaced all the social commentary and nuance with pictures of Jason Aldean pretending to be poor. You'll love it, you fucking moron. Punisher Skulls, Punisher Skulls, Punisher Skulls. Conveniently located in the town you were born in, will die in, and will never comprehend the world outside of.
And the Mean Boys podcast returns to bring back one of our favorite games, one of the earliest Mean Boy games we ever played. A little game of porn comment or Yelp review.
This is the worst Indian place in Brentwood.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I thought we had the little...
Oh, no, Do we?
What's up? It's not a big deal if we don't.
We don't.
All right. Well, never mind. Just imagine the... Pretend you heard some fuck noises, and you'll get it.
No, we still have it. I'll drop
boom,
it.
Okay, cool. Chow, wow.
That the frequency you hit on that last sound truly bothered me.
Yeah.
On like a molecular level.
Of course, a horse.
You sound like a cat being fucking power drilled to death.
Bam, chicka, wow.
Tight. Well, the rules of the game are easy. I give you a comment. You tell
still
me.
Still the soundboard.
I am the soundboard. And I've got clips up as well. You guys will be able to hear them, but not see them because no platform will let these exist. So number one, I think you burned your pizza, dude. Porn comment or Yelp review?
Ooh, that's got to be a porn comment because it doesn't fit into the narrative of a Yelp review. Like, this fucking sucks, but I think you burned your pizza, dude. Like, it doesn't quite sound like a part of an entitled rant to me.
Yeah, so I'm going to say, I think it's also porn because Yelp, no one thinks on Yelp. They know on Yelp.
Yeah.
I know you burnt your pizza, dude. Yeah.
I am the pizza doctor.
Yeah. No one on Yelp has ever been wrong or.
No. Be you pizza burning fascist.
Yeah. I will learn nothing and die furious at this Burger King.
Yeah. So I think someone probably forgot to take the pizza out of the oven as they're fucking their mom or whatever. You know, it's like that makes sense. Yeah, one guy's I'm pretty funny. I know about cooking while I'm jacking off.
Did you sure know it's legal to fuck your stepmom?
Pornos drop storylines. You know, they have loose ends. You know,
right?
Like, what happened to that quiche mom was baking before she started sucking his dick?
Not every plot hole in porn gets to be filled at the end.
You guys are right. That's a porn. It's from a porn called Triple Anal. Now, here's the thing. I included this for a reason. I pulled this up, and it's some of the most apathetic fucking I've ever seen. But I figured out it syncs to a weird music cue really well. So I just want to show you guys something real quick.
Oh yeah, let's see it or hear it.
Oh god. Oh god, that's double vaginal, isn't it?
Triple anal, as the title would tell you.
Oh, that was fucking filthy, Keith.
I didn't do it.
Oh, you didn't make that?
Oh, no, I made that. Oh, okay. I didn't make the porn, but I did find a way to rip Pornhub videos so I could put the Wile E. Coyote acne.
He's like, I've found new ways to get terrible viruses on my computer.
Oh, yeah. As soon as I did it, I'm like, I have no idea what I've done.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, they're going to be triple penetrating your files soon. Yeah.
All I have is shit like that. They're going to be fine.
Oh, no, my porn has invaded my porn.
I've never hoped that you die in an Osama bin Laden fucking scandal house more so that we can have your entire computer, just all of these videos, like.
Yeah. All right. Number two, quote, no spice, no passion. Both exclamation points. Porn or Yelp.
That's a tough one.
See, going back to what I said. Porn thinks. Yelp, they know.
Right.
It's Yelp.
I love this unifying theory of Yelp that you've developed.
I think it's a strong one, and I have to agree. This does sound, I can hear this entitled rant. I think that's a Yelp review.
Right answer. That is a Yelp review of Don Carlos Taco Shop in San Diego, California.
Oh, I miss those guys. Yeah. They're wrong. I mean,
that's like absolutely wrong. There's tons of passion, tons of flavor.
Yeah, no.
It's nothing but passion.
Yeah, it also has like meat and stuff. It's one of the best burritos in the world.
Well, I talked to that guy, and the passion, he was like, I use the waffle fries instead of regular fries in my California burritos because it holds the sour cream together better. And I'm like, that's a motherfucker who cares about my burrito experience.
Yeah, that. He had more opinions on burritos than I've ever had on anything.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you have so many opinions on burritos, too.
I'm entitled about my burritos. Number three, quote, and this is in all caps, Beyblades, let it rip!
Ooh. This is someone pulling anal beads out of a chick's ass, 100%. This is a porn comment.
Okay.
Ooh. I probably wrote it.
Yeah.
Because I was a Beyblade watcher when I was a young man. I'm ashamed to admit.
I never got it. Was Beyblades a show?
It was a show, and you had the little tops you could get.
I remember the tops. I didn't know that there was, like, lore.
I got some of the tops, and I was trying to get my neighbors into it, and they're like, Connor, you're gay. G-A-Y.
Was it like a show, like a Yu-Gi-Oh! Type thing?
It was exactly like a Yu-Gi-Oh! Type thing, where this top has this kind of core, and then a magic dragon comes out and fights the other guy's magic dragon, and
okay,
it's all a lot more involved. And then they just kind of go pink, 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 tonk.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like a very exciting fight.
It's fun, you know. It's something to do. It's not homework.
Yeah, they're like metal tornadoes.
You're getting poetic about it.
Damn.
The steel tornadoes vie for dominance.
So did this neither knows something or asks a question. It's just a statement referencing something that used to be, and only real 90s kids are super deep into porn. So I'm going to say, I'm going to say porn.
That is porn. I'll show you guys a quick clip.
Oh, hell yeah.
Called Raw Uncut Passionate Sex. Not a creative title.
I noticed that the name is Suki Suki Girl.
Wait for it. I accidentally pulled this back a little further than I needed.
Oh, shitty. This is a full 360 ever leaving her vagina. I've never seen that move before.
Yeah, I showed that to Jordan, and she pointed out, you can tell that she looks down because she is about to laugh at this dude parkour in her fucking snatch.
Yeah, I've never seen a fuck you cartwheel before.
A fart wheel, because in the ass.
Yeah. Oh, that was in her ass?
I'm just saying it to justify the fart pun.
Oh, yeah.
I don't actually know which hole he's in. I'm not a doctor.
We have journalistic integrity here in this podcast, Keith.
I'll print a retraction for the game. Number four, quote, this guy's trying to be all tough, but he's hysterical.
This is a Yelp review of the bar that Tom works at.
I'll tell you preemptively, it's not that, because I did try to find a Tom-based review, and it seems like they were all scrubbed. Tom has been completely redacted from his bar's Yelp page.
The man in black.
Sorry, can we minimize the port? I'm just.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, jacking it's a little his giant dick off in the ads.
I gotta tell you guys, I spent like 20 minutes before you got here being like, this is so cool. I can do like visuals with the game now, and you guys have looked so bummed out.
Yeah, yeah.
I forget that this game does turn into me just showing you pornography.
Yeah, it's fun.
It's like hot, but like, you know.
Yeah, I mean, I'm impressed by that last guy. Actually, I'm impressed by that last girl, because I don't know what shift she had to do in her vagina. Like, I don't know how that happened.
Yeah, you got to have a real hard dick to spin around 360 on it. They're doing, like, lazy doggy with the girl laying down on the bottom and the guy just on top. And he just did a full 360 from head around to head around with his, like, feet on top of her head at one point at the apex of the turn.
I've never had a boner I trusted that much. No. I would do, like, the flip-around pole vault scenario.
Like, I was just watching that going, ow, 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 ow.
I did watch that, and like at one point when he's completely facing the wrong way, I'm like, okay, just doing that seems like it might be kind of interesting.
Reverse cowgirl for the man.
Yeah, reverse cowboy. Yeah.
What was the review again?
This guy's trying to be all tough, but he's hysterical.
Oh, I'm going to say Yelp.
Okay.
I'm Yelp.
Okay, that is a porn comment. That is from a video that I promise I will not show you called Baseball Bat Anal Lesson.
You're not going to show it?
You know what? I'll show you the first 5 seconds, but it's nothing's going in anybody. I want to show you the tough guy in question.
Okay.
All right. Let's see how tough this motherfucker really is.
I'm imagining a guy with a toothpick in his mouth and one of those hats.
Although anybody with a baseball bat in their ass is tougher than me.
Oh my God. Oh wow.
Describe this man, Tom.
White Tyson. He's got Mike Tyson's fucking tattoo. He doesn't look. Yeah. Oh boy.
He's dressed like a mobster in a Mad TV sketch.
Yeah, it's like a Party City Guys and Dolls costume.
Yeah.
This, look, I'm going to be honest. When I look at this, the first thing I thought is like, this is what Luis Gomez thinks he looks like.
This is Post Malone before he grew out the hair. This is pre-Malone. Yeah.
Luis Gay Gomez.
Nice. All right, number whatever. Quote, no more nerds talking. They're not rock stars. They're college graduates with social anxiety.
Wait, one more time?
No more nerds talking. They're not rock stars. They're college graduates with social anxiety.
This could very easily be a review of any bar trivia night.
Yeah, you know? I mean,
because those people act like gods.
Right.
Yeah. And porn stars, I don't care what the plot is. They're not in college. So I don't think it's that. I'm going to go Yelp. Can we minimize it? This is an ad of one cartoon going down on another cartoon.
I'm sorry.
No, or like a cartoon gif of a guy getting his dick sucked that just said better than hookers.
I mean, probably. Like a cartoon character?
No, I mean, it's just not like it was like an ad for a service that was better than hookers.
Oh, okay. I thought it was the cartoon pussy pizza.
Which, I don't know. Was that a hooker that gives you a pizza?
Yeah.
Pizza Hook. Yelp.
You're on Yelp?
Yelp.
Okay, that is Yelp. That is for BattleBots Live in Las Vegas. next one, quote, women should not take Trenbolone. Which what? I will say, Trenbolone is a powerful steroid.
Hello, my name is Trenbolone. I am the powerful steroid. I make the women very skinny.
I keep you so thin, so wet.
I make you very thin. Wafer thin. My name is Trenbolone. Do you want to be all balloon with me? I know that you do. Yeah, women should not take me. I'm very dangerous. I am worse than Ozempic.
I don't know where that guy's from, but I want to live there. Women shouldn't take Trenbolone. This sounds, what is it? What is it? What drug is it? Is that again?
It's a steroid.
It's a steroid. You know, maybe that sounds like a porn comment for like a big old buff chick, some guy being mean.
Yeah, I'm trying to think. There are. See, but yeah, it's obviously a buff chick. The question is she railing some dude or is she at a gym?
Interesting.
I'm gonna switch it up. I'm gonna go gym.
All right, that is a porn comment from a video called Brooke Diesel has new boobs. Brooke Diesel has new boobs. I won't make you look at them, but they're horrifying. Next quote: apparently, they don't want lesbian money.
This sounds like something a lesbian would write on Yelp.
Yeah, this is, I think, yeah.
All right, that is Yelp. That is for Fatty Patties in Indianapolis, Indiana.
Why would lesbians not want, why would lesbians be in Indiana?
Yeah, that's a good question.
I don't know, they couldn't escape before the fucking, the cage went up.
A terrible fucking mishap.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, people got to know what Fatty Patties is important. There was a strip club that's supposed to have a bunch of BBW strippers in it. We found out about it in Texas, and it was all the way in Indiana, and we were going to go up there on tour. And we're the whole fucking trip from Texas to Indiana, we had visions of big fucking booty sugar plums dancing in our heads. And then we get to Fatty Patties.
Well, hang on. First, we learned the friend that told us to go. First, we learned it's not called Fatty Patties.
No.
I forgot what it's called.
But it's just called Patties.
Yeah. We kept Googling Fatty Patties, and it didn't exist.
Right.
And then, sorry, I wanted to add that detail.
No, I forgot about that. That is true. It's just colloquially known as Fatty Patties.
Yeah.
And then we get there, and there's like three depressed strippers and one guy with no money.
I do remember a stripper dancing and then going up to the one guy and being like, have a dollar. And he just went, nah, and then walked out. And then we texted, it was Keith Ray, told us about it. We texted him, we're like, there were no fat chicks. And he just goes, the biggins come at night.
The biggins will come.
All right, two more. Quote, white people destroyed the whole world and took all the land resources.
Oh, this is so out of left field. It's got to be a porn comment. Because, like, what is this, a review of, like, the UN headquarters or
no,
something?
No, Pier 1, the whitest place in America.
Oh, shit, that's really good.
Wait, where?
Pier 1.
Pier 1 Imports.
Oh, Pier 1 Imports.
I'm going Yelp.
The wicker furniture of the colonizer. All right, that is a porn, and I want to show you, there's no sex in this, but I'm going to show you just the first 5 seconds of this porn before I tell you the title. Don't look at the screen for a minute.
Okay. Averting my eyes. Waiting for Keith to pull up pornography again.
All right, you guys ready?
Yeah.
Oh, it's Burn Booth. Oh.
Oh. KKK2 Le Incesto.
Yeah, it's an Italian KKK incest porn.
Oh, my God.
Which I scrolled through it just trying to see how much of the plot I could track down in Italian. It seems to have the same ending as the movie Old Boy, and that's all I know.
What?
Somehow leaving this on the screen feels weirder than leaving the porn up.
Yeah, what we saw, gang, was the fires of hell, and then a Klansman emerged through them. And then, of course, the title KKK2, Le Incesto. I do like that there's a holy, there's like spaghetti westerns and there's spaghetti jizz, and spaghetti porn.
All right, last one. Quote, keep hanging around fast food outlets and you could gather a harem in a week.
That's a comment from my comedy special.
That is correct.
I believe responding to my joke about my love for the BBWs.
Indeed. It is, yeah, that is a comment from your comedy special. We were talking about, and this is a segue to the sketch. We were talking about BBW Highway the other day.
Yeah.
Which if you don't live on the edge, BBW Highway is a BBW porn site that me and Connor are both fans of. And one night I was listening to the Drive soundtrack and getting ready to jerk off. And I had a weird, I want to be clear, that's not how I usually prep. Like, I don't put on my jacket with the scorpion, my fucking fingerless jacking gloves. But I was doing that and I was like, you know what would be a funny thing to do is write a theme song for BBW Highway. And I'm going to share it with you guys here. And I am going to send this. They do have a contact page. So I'm going to send this song to BBW Highway.
Fuck yeah.
And see if I can get them to use it in one video. I don't want to tell them it's from Meme Boys because I don't want them to realize that it's a comedy thing. So it will be coming from a new band called Daft Chunk. So yeah, enjoy BBW Highway and we'll be back with the fucking mailbag.
There's a road where legends go in the dead of night. A road that leads to passion. A road that leads to desire. A road they call the BBW Highway. Cruising online and the night's getting late. I have an urge to jerk and it cannot wait. I need some babes, some freaky baddies. Not normal size, I get hard for fatties. Keep your skinny supermodels. My girls wiggle when they waddle. When I hear the sound of a ranch dressing bottle, I unzip my pants and I hit the throttle. Taking a ride on BBW Highway. They've got the hottest whoppers, and they let me have it my way. Only real men can handle this road because it's got dangerous curves, like medically dangerous where you might not fit on a roller coaster. Chubby in the front and sweaty in the back, those are the girls that make me want to jack. 10 pounds of fine in a 2-ton sack, honey-baked honeys looking like a snack. Let me get lost in your luscious flaps. Sit on my face and make my spine collapse. I don't care about your gout or your diabetic sickness. Girl, you know I'm down with the thickness. Come take a ride down BBW Highway. They've got the hottest whoppers, and they let me have it my way.
Hi, welcome to Jack in the Box. Can I take your order?
I'm looking for the woman of my dreams. A dairy queen to rock my world. Thick thighs save lives, and brother, I'm drowning. I need some honking butt cheeks to carry me to the shores of ecstasy.
Hang on, let me check. Hey, Mauricio, we got any super fat manic pixie dream girls in there? I don't know, man. This guy's asking me, so I'm asking you. Nah, man, we don't have those. We're a Jack in the Box. We got, like, cheeseburgers and stuff.
Oh, okay. Do you have those mini tacos?
Hang on, let me check. Hey, Mauricio! No, it's not about the fat chick thing. Do we still got the mini tacos? Nah, man, sorry. Those are just a sometimes thing.
Then it looks like the road is calling. If it takes forever, I'll drive forever. Riding those white lines and chasing those taillights like phantoms. Until I find my wide load rolling down the road out here on the BBW Highway.
Welcome back to the Mean Boys Podcast. It's time to fucking open up the Mean Boys mailbag.
It's a Mean Boys mailbag. Fuck everything. God is dead. Send us an email or give us a call. Have you ever heard the one about you?
right, there's been all these fun like moments of discovery bringing the show back, and I forgot how hard that fucking mailbag jingle goes.
Yeah, I had a full blown dance party in my pants when that shit came on. That shit goes hard.
Yeah, I was just talking to fucking our boy Andrew Hillary, who made that the other day. But yeah, let's get in the mail. Also, we have a bajillion voicemails, bajillion comments. We're gonna go through some, but if you don't get played on this one,
it's because we hate you.
Yeah, we have a personal vendetta against you, but we're gonna get to everybody. But here's one from our buddy Short Bus Murphy.
Mean boys, what's up? Short Bus Murphy here. I couldn't fucking believe when I woke up early on 9/11 to clean some bugs and saw that the fucking show is back. What a miracle. It's been a wild couple of years since you last heard from your boy. I had Tom up there for some misadventures right after Halloween last time. And then, you know, COVID hit, got married. Paid off my house, fucking rejoined my old jam band, playing bass now. Check me out, Adam Ghost, that's A-T-O-M Ghost. Fucking started booking comedy at the Elks Lodge. I'm an elk now, didn't see that one coming. Getting involved in a local theater restoration project and a lot of other local charities and stuff. Thinking about getting a van and turning it into like a mobile camper in case the old lady kicks me out. Fucking this weekend, I think I'm going to go drop some acid and see string cheese incident. And also thinking about running for town council. So, you know, got a lot of shit going on, man, but I'm so glad you guys are back. I hope to keep it going for a while. All right, fuck everything God has said.
Wow.
Yeah, what's up? I'm going to be part of the local government. I'm going to live in a car soon. I'm anticipating a divorce.
I got married. I'm planning on the divorce.
I want to see this campaign commercial. Just, he's the man with the plan and the van.
I've never heard someone more ambitiously doing nothing. Yeah. The guy was like, getting the jam band back together. Like, that's fuck.
Short Bus Murphy, change. You will regret.
Well, hey, let us know about the campaign. We'd be happy to lend you our support.
What we should do is like write campaign songs and like actively write attack ads against Short Bus. Oh. That would be the better move.
Well, it probably might be the best way to get him some press.
We're just going to become the Roger Stone of small town politics.
Did you know that Short Bus Murphy has left 58 1-minute plus voicemails to an obscure comedy podcast?
What was Short Bus Murphy doing on 9/11? Was he honoring the country or was he calling three autists? All right, let's play another one. Oh, shit, Biggity Bob.
Holy shit, I just listened to the episode back and I'm fucking just turgid with happiness. It is Biggity Bob. NorCal's legend, who now lives in Oklahoma and is now an over-the-road truck driver.
I'm going to pause real quick. I do love how many of our calls it like include what vehicle I am currently most likely to be found dead in.
My current house / mode of transportation is.
Yeah. So, fellas, for the next one, I really hope we bring back Andrew Hillary's jingle.
Goddamn right.
For the Mean Boys mailbag, because he is still quite active on the old Instagram and Twitter. Still going. So, let's see. When can I meet Tom Goss? Since I've met Connor twice and Keith like 9 times and even Jordan once, when can I meet Tom? That's my question. When are you guys coming to Oklahoma?
Oh, shit.
Well, later, fellas.
I went to Sacramento, and then you decided to move to Oklahoma. So,
that's on you, bud.
Yeah, you're a moving target.
I went to you, and then you went elsewhere. You went to what I've publicly said on this show is, I think, my second least favorite state.
What is your least favorite?
Indiana.
I think we've fought about this, but I think yeah. I go Indiana or Oklahoma under Indiana.
Yeah, yeah, I think so, too. At least Indiana has, like, strip malls.
I also like that we are 2 for 2 on voicemails that have gone, like, so what's going on? All the burning desire.
Yeah, I finally get to ask you, sup?
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I'll try to stop avoiding you.
Every time I ran into Bob in Sacramento, he would just ask where you were, as though I was going to be like, all right, you caught me. He's in the bathroom. Like, I would tell him, like, Tom's not here. And he'd be like, I reject that as a statement of fact.
Yeah.
I also like that our voicemail auto-corrected fellas to phallus in that.
Well, it's also funny, the amount of times that people have told me after shows are over that they were at a show, usually it's a show where I'm like, oh, this I hate this show. I'm going to kind of decide to phone it in. And then afterwards I get a tweet like, I was scared to say hi to you.
I was so nervous to approach the mighty Goss.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. We got another one here.
Hey, mean boys. Saw y'all a couple years back in Dallas, Texas. Since then, I got divorced. Just wanted to say thanks for coming back and talking.
Yeah, I'm not allowed to call her, so I'm going to call you instead. You said that like it was our fault.
Yeah, like, well, the two things were clearly connected.
Two of the three people we've, the first three voicemails are either about to or did get divorced.
Which it does, I mean, yeah, it does. It doesn't not make sense that we attract the about to be divorced crowd.
I was saying before we started the show, I forgot that our voicemail acted like as like a BetterHelp service for lonely podcast listeners. Where it's like, I just need to get this off my chest. I haven't left the house in 14 days.
Yeah, it's like phone sex for the concept of somebody caring about you.
Yeah.
That's really what we are.
I miss her so much.
I mean, yeah, that sucks. I don't know. I just haven't gotten married. That's why I haven't been divorced. At least, what'd Shakespeare say? Shot the jets at her face or what? Yeah, you did it. You did it, and it didn't work out. You'll get another
one. Which play
is
that from?
I don't know.
Brothello?
Yeah, Brothello. Yeah. No, I'm riffing poorly right now, but what the important thing is things will get better. Or they won't. I don't know anymore.
I'll give you the advice that my dearly departed friend Nathan Camp gave me after a breakup. You have to imagine your ex getting fucked by dozens of black guys. That's what he said was the best way to get over a breakup.
That makes sense, because then you have nothing to fear. You've just pictured the worst case scenario for your insecurity. Is that the idea, or am I missing it?
You know, all he said as a follow up was, that shit's medicine, con man.
All right, fucking let's play this one. Oh, where'd it go?
Shit. I like that you just admitted your biggest fear is black guys.
No, I thought that was the point he was making. Is like, oh, you picture your ex getting fucked really well by a bunch of like very manly dudes. Mm.
I think that's basically the idea.
Yeah,
it could have been.
That's
a bunch
what I thought too. And then you guys looked at me like I was crazy.
No, could
have been a bunch of Urkels. We didn't say what kind of black people these were.
Yeah, imagine your girlfriend getting fucked by a flock of Urkels.
Donald Glover laying it down.
Oh shit. I do not want to open airplay with what we've been doing here. All right, here we go.
You assholes. I was listening to the Spotify shuffle of News, Bach Cello Suites, and Slayer, and suddenly a new episode shows up. I mean, I'm glad, but you disappear through the entirety of COVID. And now you come back. I just got resigned to the idea of you being gone. Yeah, this is the guy who went to jail and called you.
Right. Fuck
beforehand.
Yeah.
No, Connor, I didn't strangle anyone. I took a plea deal because I tried to take care of someone who drunkenly fell into furniture, knocked me out when I tried to get her to the hospital, and then just let the police take their own little foray down to... I'm sorry, this is babbling.
All right, here's what we know about this caller so far. Number one, he definitely did something bad and violent. And number two, he's mad at us for some reason.
Well, I just like that this is now evidence in this ongoing court case, if someone is keen enough to find it.
Your Honor, if it pleases the court, we'll fast forward past all the weird porn shit.
So did the furniture do time too?
Let the record show that mailbag jingle did indeed slap.
Basically, I spent the last 6 years trying to get some sort of habeas corpus, the last year and a half of which involved finding out that there was a photo that proved I didn't do anything. And I was trying to do this all while I was off medication because I wasn't allowed to get it in there. So I'm glad to hear that you're back, but God damn.
I'm so
probably be a drunken version of this. But yeah, it's try to take care of someone and got screwed over for it when she
I need him to be more clear about what he means when he says take care of someone.
Well, she was. It sounds like she was drunk and he was trying to get her, you know, to the bed or whatever, to get her right. And then she tripped on the furniture and thought it was him and then got in a fight. It does sound like, you know, you kind of got boned by the old legal system, man. I'm sorry to hear that. And I'm sorry if we made you feel bad riffing about your issue the last time. I do think, fuck, what was I going to say?
I'll say something. If you give us information, we are probably going to make fun of it.
Oh, I just wanted to say,
yeah.
True. But when we were gone during COVID, when all this was, that stuff was happening, and you looked down and you only saw one set of footprints in the sand, that was because we were ignoring you.
We were elsewhere, away from the beach.
Yeah.
Failed to take forensics, and no one believes that a guy didn't attack a girl, especially when it's the real story is that a girl attacked a guy who's 6'1", outweighs her by like twice her weight. I let her take a shot at me because it was the only way that she would get in the car. It was, she gets to hit me and I get to leave. She hit me in the left temple. It would be a hilarious arrest video if it wasn't for the fact that it was so sad and they pulled guns on a guy who was unconscious. Anyway, yeah, the reason why I locked on to you guys, I don't know about the rest of the people that have the various and sundry reasons, but during that time, like, I wasn't allowed in the county because she said she was scared of me. Shouldn't have been, but, you know, she's kind of projecting. Anyway, I was in the middle of the country alone with just my parents. And you're kind of dark. You have to laugh at the darkness, otherwise the darkness wins. And all the people that I had that I could do with that, they all lived 4 miles away or 4 hours away. 4 miles. 4 miles would have been easy.
Yep.
So, yeah, I focused in on you guys. And that's why you were the only ones that you can't vent to the people who love you. Not when they're fragile. My mom's on her like.
Wait, when did I leave this voicemail?
Man, I've never longed so much for the emotional simplicity of the Grandpatron.
Yeah. Like,
all right, I think the next one might be him finishing.
Yeah, I ramble. Yes, I'm autistic. I'm on the spectrum.
What?
Just enough that I'm on permanent disability and I hate it. Anyway, yeah, but you have to laugh at the darkness. And when you don't have anyone but people who are fragile, like I said, my mom had like 5 back surgeries at now. I'm taking care of her on her 9th at this point. She couldn't take it. My dad had to deal with her and me.
You damn, need this guy's mom keeps
get
getting his black.
Laugh at life with.
Does one and of these buttons have a violin?
You guys were the closest thing. You did a good job. It would have been nice if it wasn't as one-sided, but in the country, where do you find someone who can, you know, make jokes about Pantera? And,
Pantera.
You know, just everything that's wrong.
Have we ever done a Pantera?
And funny because if you don't.
I'm sure
laugh,
we made a Dimebag Darrell reference at some point.
I'm glad you're back, but goddamn, really, you missed the entirety of COVID.
You know, COVID happened to us too, right? We didn't just go into the fucking cryosleep pod from Alien. Like, we've been around.
Yeah.
I had a whole other podcast you didn't listen to with Tom.
Okay, there'll probably be more random babblings, but, you know, it's good to see you back. You better not disappear again, and I didn't do it, and I'm trying to prove it. Wish me luck.
You
love
better
you
not. This was the most
fuck
codependent
everything.
Voicemail.
God is dead.
You better not leave.
Good luck, bud.
I was innocent.
Oh, boy.
That voicemail could have very easily been from Kanye West.
That was, look, I know we're dunking on you, but, like, I almost said I'm glad you're feeling better, but I don't know if I'd call that better. I'm glad you like the show, and I'm glad we make you feel a little less. I'm glad we make you feel less lonely. I believe you.
Yeah, man, we're team you. You know, yeah.
I don't believe
that other lady didn't leave us a voicemail.
Yeah, I don't believe you're autistic.
You're faking it.
Yeah, I think you're faking it. No, yeah, I don't. I got a little sensory overload on all the information you gave, but yeah, I'm glad that you're happy we're back, and I hope things get better. I think it seems like it's been a rough couple years.
I think that you were wrongly convicted in your conviction that you're good at talking.
We should.
I think it's really imperative you not represent yourself in court.
Dude, do not like, do that.
I don't care how innocent you are, dog. Find like a slick Jew to like help you out of this one.
Yeah, you made yourself sound like Sketchy Larry. Like you could not have sounded guiltier. And man, let me tell you about this bitch, man.
Yeah. All right.
Hey, Mean Boys. Peter. Long time poor love. You know me. I'm that weirdo who always posts the BDSM pictures on your Discord.
Oh, yeah.
I don't really have much to say. It's just wanting to say I'm glad you're back. I'm glad you're back. Hey.
Nice long chunk.
Oh, shit. I forgot.
No, it's fucking that song.
Oh, yeah. Glad you're back.
CJ, who it was kind of funny because I kept tabs a little bit on the Mean Boys Discord while the show was gone. And it was like there were a few people just kind of keeping the lights on. And a lot of it was just him posting pictures of his dick and like people he tied up. Like who were into it.
Yeah, like, yeah. Not like to the railroad tracks.
Yeah. So I'm glad you're back, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, keeping the dick pics flowing.
All right, let's. You want to do one more?
Yeah, I'll do one more. Get in the comments.
All right.
Hey, Mean Boys. This here's Bucky from Kentucky again. Say I'm real glad y'all are coming back. I've been building a house, doing all the work myself for the past year or two, and it's just good to be able to listen to a podcast while I'm up there running wire in the rafters. But wanted to ask you a question. Being out and about in the country, I have had my fair share of encounters with wild animals. My buddy actually threw a deer in the air, grabbed it by the horns one time, threw it up about 4 feet in the air, and landed in the creek. So that was pretty interesting. I have never had a altercation with a large mammal, but I did have a 25-minute standoff with an Alaskan moose. I was naked as a bird's ass pluck. The moose was naked as a bird's ass pluck, but we came to an agreement and the moose moved on. Anyway, my question for you is the largest land mammal you each think you could defeat in combat? I'm assuming Tom's going for the largest, but I wanted to know your thoughts and your opinions. Again, I'm real glad y'all are back. Y'all have a good one. Come out to Kentucky anytime. All right, bye.
Why was it skipping and what?
I don't know why it was skipping.
What did he say?
What was the question?
So number one, his accent was so thick that Google Voice thought that was spam. the most powerful AI in the world went, oh, I don't know, man.
Yeah.
He's saying, what is the largest land mammal that you think you could defeat in combat?
I do like that he had this weird shamanic moment where I was naked with the buck and the buck was naked with me and we came to an understanding.
Yeah, we spoke into each other's souls and we were as one.
We fused our butts together like Avatar.
Anyway, I'm running from the police, and I live in Winnipeg. Largest land mammal. He thinks you're going to pick a pretty big one.
I think I could take Bucky from Kentucky.
Oh, Bucky from Kentucky, I think, could kill all of us at once.
I don't know. He sounded sweet and thin.
A little bit of wispy energy.
Yeah, I got big wispy vibes from him. I think he's the largest land mammal I could take down.
And this is in hand-to-hand combat.
I think that's the implication.
Hand to hoof, hand to paw.
Yeah.
If
I have a big enough gun, I can take down any land mammal.
Yeah. I'm gonna go cow.
Yeah, I guess that is probably correct.
And even then that'll be difficult, but I'll have to soothe it first, get on top, rear naked choke.
Oh, that's
okay, that's a porn
mood.
Comment.
I was picturing you boxing the cow, like trying to knock it out.
That would be way harder. No, sometimes you gotta beat people with intelligence.
No, I like to.
And these
cows
people,
are
these,
people.
These people are cows.
Well, and cows are pretty kind of docile once they're like domesticated. So if you could just climb on its back and then just fucking surprise it with the rear naked choke, you'd have to. Do you think you're strong enough to close the cow's windpipe? I think so.
Oh, that's. I'm not going to close its windpipe. I'm going to shut off its blood flow.
Oh.
Is that different?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, like, is that a different amount of strength?
No. It's more technique than strength. Now, the question is, are my arms long enough to get all the way around the cow's neck?
That's a good question.
I have very short arms because I think I can ride the cow. I think I'll trick it with oats or something, whatever cows eat.
Well, this is hand to hand. Oats count as a weapon here. You got to do this with just pure animal husbandry.
You got your charms is what you got to use to woo this cow.
I'll woo the cow. I'll get on top of it. It'll probably freak the fuck out. I will use my powerful quads to stay on the cow and sink it a rear naked choke. And then, therefore,
that is
stop
why
the blood flow to its brain.
Breaking news, man killed by cow for first time ever. Mourned by few.
Yeah.
Raped extensively.
Parentheses, yes, we know cows are girls. They still found a way.
Yeah, it would be like cows are tougher than people give them credit for.
I didn't say I was going to kill one.
Yeah. I wouldn't want to kill one.
But if I had to. And some sort of Bucky from Kentucky Thunderdome.
If I'm trying to prove Bucky wrong, then that would probably be that, yeah.
I don't want to overestimate my ability to kill a big mammal. Like maybe like a pretty sick dog. You know? Like a cat who like one of his eyes is all fucked up.
You could just step on him kind of thing.
I really need it to be like previously damaged is what I need. I just need to be the finishing blow.
Yeah. I was thinking I could maybe take out a shitty coyote. Like I could just kick him to death.
Okay. Shitty coyote?
Yeah, you know, like the weak one.
Yeah.
Like the one that Scar doesn't hang out with.
Fucking whatever, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. Coyotes alone are not that. I mean, yeah, we could probably beat up a coyote. I mean, we'd take some damage, but we could beat up a coyote. The problem is they roll in crews.
Oh, and you gotta fuck with his boys.
Yeah. Because coyotes chase me sometimes when I jog. And you got to turn around, you got to shine a light at them, show them that you're not intimidated. But if there's a bunch of them, it starts getting a little scary.
So, okay, yeah, I'm really disappointed it took me this long to find that you've been fighting coyotes with flashlights. I'm kind of mad that you didn't tell me this earlier.
Oh, I thought, when I jog at night, that's why I kind of stop jogging at night, is because they'll follow you.
There's no animal that doesn't follow you at some point.
It
feels like a lot of your stories are about, and then blank animals started chasing me.
This cat was following me. This skunk was following me. You know.
Well, I just live where there are coyotes. You know? It's not like I'm.
And they're going, what the fuck kind of dog is this? This is crazy.
Are we supposed to eat it or worship it? What is that?
Yeah. Well, I'm not very tall, but they can feel my lack of fear. I'm there to brawl with them if that's what they want. It's on them.
It's up to you how bad you're going to get hurt, coyote.
Yeah. All I wanted to do was get some little bit of cardio in, but you're going to follow me. I'll take you down.
Ramsey Badawi says, do you guys plan on having Ramsey Badawi on? Yeah, exactly. Nah, that's going to be a no for me, dog.
Yeah, we don't do no-name comedians on the show. No, of course we're going to have Ramsey on.
Yeah. Terry Ryan says, what have your other characters been doing since the show ended?
All two of my characters?
Well, three now. Trenbolone is an all-timer.
Trenbolone.
See, Trenbolone.
I like the buff cheeks. They can hold me so tight.
They are mucho dense.
I have been in the Poconos, poking hose. I've been hanging out with Hunter Biden, doing coke off a laptop, if you know what I mean. Oh, doggy. He likes the strong stuff.
I don't know. Tammy's just Tammy. Tammy actually died three times, but she's still kicking.
Oh, good for her.
Yeah. I've got a bunch of hearts, like how a cow has stomachs.
I live forever. Death is temporary. Life just keeps going and going and going like my puss.
I got really into Overwatch.
Ace Hole stormed the Capitol.
Ace Hole.
It's not even politically, just like breaking windows.
Yeah. Ace Hole walking here towards the sun. Might as well be doing it. Smash Mouth died. So sad. Fuck.
I felt bad. Somebody brought up Officer Money in the comments, and I was like, I fucking forgot Officer
Dude,
Money.
Dude, I saw that too. I loved Officer Money.
What was his deal? He kind of sounded like Joe Jack, and he was the right to remain banked or whatever.
He was Officer Money. He was a cop, but with money, Keith. It's not that complicated. complicated.
I know, but and yet if I do it wrong, it feels wrong.
But who have you arrested since the you know, the, with all the financial scandals going on, Officer Money?
Oh, those everybody who made those NFTs, they went. That stands for not fucking. Not going the to money. Jail. Officer Money.
Not fucking tight.
Yeah. I choked out Martin Shkreli.
I beat Sam Bakeman Fried with a stick.
It was like the George Floyd thing, but they threw me a parade instead.
Yeah, and you'll like you heard from Carnock last week. You'll hear from a couple other favorites.
Yeah, you'll be hearing from Mark Malloy soon.
Yeah, yeah. Mark Malloy's coming.
I've almost figured out whether or not I'm a character on the show.
You know, I think by the end of these 10, we might have that cracked.
Yeah,
yeah.
I'm still undecided.
Daniel Bott says, "Bring back the Southern lawyer Foghorn Leghorn accent."
Well, Your Honor, I'm just a simple country lawyer. Ooh.
I do declare I've got a case of the vapors here in this here podcast room.
I grew up in a shotgun house in the Appalachians, and I never was one for big city learning, but I do know.
It's a time to be lawyering here in this here establishment.
You kind of almost are doing Italian.
Mamma mia, I'm from Mississippi.
It's like when Brad Pitt has to be Italian in Inglourious Bastards. So,
Your Honor, that guy who called Mean Boys was clearly innocent, as you can see from all the times he said so.
Your Honor, he didn't mean to call her a bitch, but when you look at the facts, I mean, come on.
Your Honor, have you considered that she should have shut up?
Your Honor, she pushed him in the left temple. He passed out. Now, how is a passed out man supposed to beat up a woman?
It makes you tweak your suspenders in rage.
Well, just a lot of people saying we love the Mean Boys. Mean Boys are great. I'm gay for Mean Boys. Pull up one of the other. Sorry, there's so many comments to get through, but most of them are just people going, yeah, 9/11.
I saw Ron Swallow commented, how does it feel to go from Mean Boys to recalcitrant men? And I don't know what recalcitrant means.
I assume it means mean, but you went to college.
Steroids that lady was on. She ran out of the Trenbolone.
That's the Luigi to Trenbolone's Mario.
Yeah. I was snorting recalcitrant off the French Alps.
Okay, here we go.
Googling the...
Oh, oops. Sorry, I'm accidentally playing the fucking the demo video. Oh, by the way, the videos that we posted, I think I told you this, but I forget. Or no, I think I told one of you guys. So when we were sitting on the roof of Pac Pal shooting that video, my ass was burning so bad. And I felt like such a baby because I kept complaining about it and you guys were like, fine, even though it was hot.
No, my ass was burning up.
Okay, because what I found out is that I had 50 cents in my wallet. And it had gotten so hot that it burned a perfect 2/4-sized hole through my pants.
Oh, my God. That's amazing.
Yeah, I literally torched my own ass.
One time, it was like the middle of July when I was a little kid. My dad was getting in his Honda Accord, and there was a dime that was sitting on the front seat of the passenger seat. And the dime burned his ass through his jeans so bad, you could see Alexander Hamilton's face on his fucking ass cheek. Or Thomas Jefferson, I think.
Calvin Coolidge.
On the dime?
Pretty sure.
You know, sometimes you office of money, sometimes the money offices you.
Who's on the dime?
Franklin D. Roosevelt. We're all wrong.
Oh, yeah. Hell yeah. Fucking stupid. Officer Money, come arrest the whole show. That was bad.
You're under for arrest for dimes against humanity.
Oh, you found it.
Yeah, Officer Money is back, baby. Hey, cab. All cabs are bajillionaires.
Okay, here's a fun one. What was your worst or best first date with somebody? That's from Domini Damari.
Have I ever told the story about the girl with the pots?
I don't remember, but tell it again.
That's too vague and both too specific use of a noun.
So I go to this drama festival, and I've got this con going where I don't have to do any acting because I'm the costume model, and I'm just modeling this costume of Julius Caesar the costume chicks are making. So I'm just hanging out at this festival dressed as Julius Caesar.
Okay.
And I meet this chick, and I'm kind of spitting game as Julius Caesar, right? And I'm like in like 10th grade, 11th grade. I just got my like learner's permit, and we hook up on you know, like AIM, and we talk, you know. Every night, or we kind of start this kind of like long distance thing. And then eventually my parents are out of town and I can sneak out of the house and I can go see her. She lives up in like Calabasas. And I get to her place in Calabasas and you walk in and the whole house was just filled with clay pots. Like everywhere there was blank space on the ground, there was a clay pot. and it looked like one of those rooms in Legend of Zelda.
I was just going to say.
Where you go and smash all the pots and get the rupees.
Right.
And I'm like, what is going on with all these pots? And she's like, my dad makes them. And I'm like, is it his job? And she's like, well, he's sold one of them. And this guy had just quit his really high-paying executive job to be in a Buddhist cult. And he was like in the house chanting, like we heard, like, I'm Nam Sheda Fungi Weda Foto Shinga. And I'm like, is that a CD? And she's like, no, that's my dad chanting.
That's horrifying.
Yeah. And the whole date was just kind of awkward. Like, we're just sitting there watching Family Guy while he was this Buddhist guy was kind of glaring at me, like with his daughter. I think we kissed by a tree. It was just nothing. It was too weird at the crib.
Yeah, and it's like there's no way to make a move around the pots and the weird Buddha dad.
Because now I'm like, well, I know I definitely don't want to fuck with this guy's dad. You know what I mean? Like, it's like you just raised the stakes on the dad. You know, it's like a weird hippie version of like the weird racist obsessive, like, you know, possessive dad.
Yeah, there's no coming back from that.
So that's probably my worst first date.
You got a memorable one, Tom?
Oh, I mean, they don't really happen, and when they do, they're all so bad.
I've got one of you still.
Yeah.
And I might have told this story on the show. I forget if I ever told you guys about the Disneyland date that went awry.
Not sure.
So when I was working at Disneyland, there was this girl who I met when I was working at like the employee cafeteria, and she would come in all the time, and we'd, you know, flirt a little bit or whatever, and finally it was like, oh, do you want to, like, you know, hang out sometime? She was like, we'll hang out at Disneyland because we got in for free. It was a good date spot. And we started hanging out, and it just became clear this was the most annoying person I'd ever met in my life. She was just, like, big time, like, adult Disney kid, but not in, like, the fun kind of retro way that I am. Just in, like, I'm 7, but also I'm 20.
Yes.
Like, that kind of level. And I kept trying to, like, shake her loose, but she just kept wanting to hang out, and finally I was like, I need an excuse. So I faked a phone call near Space Mountain. It said my grandpa had died. And she was like, oh, well, what do you want to go on next? Like, she didn't understand that meant I would be leaving. I was like, no, the date will now be over on account of my deceased grandfather. But then we were taking the bus the same direction. So I literally just got off the bus 90 stops before I was supposed to and just went to the movies alone. That grandpa's actually dying now. And I was like, man, I got a lot of extra grandpa years.
Wow, yeah. You could use that excuse, you know?
You worry when you fake a death of somebody for an excuse that they're going to die the next day and you're going to feel like you did it somehow.
Someone, I forget that some comedian had a thing about you got wads, your weddings, your anniversaries, and your deaths. These are your big excuses that you got to save.
Yeah.
You know, death's a big one. But that's a time to pull out a fucking big lie is when you're in the middle of an awful date.
Yeah, no, I cashed that one. Got out of that. All right, and we'll do one more question, and then we'll get out of here. Robbie says, what is an example of a costume you found to ride the line between being genuinely upsetting but also still kind of sexy? That's very specific.
Oh, man, my ex was thinking about doing sexy Thanos, and I'm like,
oh, shit.
On the one hand, I was like, that's really fucking gross with the chin and the whole thing, but I'm like, it would be hot if you were purple.
Hey, you put your balls in her hand, and they just fused to the fucking gauntlet. I get jerked off by an Infinity Gauntlet.
Yeah, I would get jerked off by a sexy Thanos.
I'm 100%. Surprised that hasn't already happened to you.
I've gotten jerked off by the gauntlet?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean,
I'm surprised that wasn't your list of demands.
Demands? I go into every date with like a notarized list. Yeah. My attorney's present.
Sexy and upsetting.
I just went to this Halloween like art fair thing with Jordan, and there was like a big thick chola dressed like a spooky clown whose job was ostensibly to like frighten you or whatever. And she it wasn't scary, but she did make my dick do stuff.
Dude, I forgot I saw this question. I had an answer ready. There was a show called Pants Off Dance Off. Remember that?
Yes.
On Fuse?
That was my jam.
Where people would like take off their clothes and they would blur it, but they would just be like dancing to a song.
Right.
There was one chick who did a weird kind of sexy goth clown thing, the sort of thick clown. I was like, I remember I had that on the DVR and would jack off to that like when my parents would just leave.
Oh, dude, I liked Pants Off Dance Off more than I liked porn.
Yeah.
Because I was like, these look like girls I know.
This
like,
was some mystery to it too, you know?
Yeah, and Fuse was like the cool kid MTV where you're like, they play Taking Back Sunday. They're fucking rad.
Yeah, they
like,
they get it.
Yeah.
I haven't seen this, but I think the what's his name? The former vice president.
That could be
Joe Biden.
People.
No.
Mike Pence?
If someone could find a way to do a sexy Mike Pence, that would absolutely be the perfect blend.
Do you want
to
come on my tits, mother?
Of terrifying. They can find a way to do it.
There you go.
Yeah, that'd be a good one.
But I don't have any good ideas.
You just got to get a buff guy with gray hair.
Oh, I was seeing the girl.
Oh, a girl doing a sexy Mike Pence.
Men can be hot, too.
I'm socially conservative and anally juicy. Yeah. My platform.
Yeah. I don't have a good answer. Do we have one more question?
I can find us one more question.
I feel like I've been bombing this. It's very weird for me because everyone's like, well, I missed you. Like, I've been here. I've been doing.
They're like, yeah, but I missed you doing the thing we like. Yeah, sorry. We got a bunch of comments. I should have prepped this a little better. That's my bad. Oh, you know what was fun? And I'll get us out of here on this because this is a fun little story. So what I liked is that once the reveal happened and everybody kind of was like, oh, my God, Mean Boys is back. The whole Discord turned into people just going like, what have you guys been like? They were all like catching up with each other or whatever. And like so many people had kids or like got married or like bought a house or whatever. But there was one really funny one.
I'd be interested to see if there's any couple that got together because they were meeting. Like there's the one couple we saw in a couple different locations that saw the shows and they kind of got together through the show. If there's ever a baby that came about because of Mean Boys.
there's the two people. I know there's a couple in San Diego. I don't want to. Yeah.
Yeah. There's a wedding. Yeah. That I know is at least tangentially Mean Boys.
They
related.
Got married. They're still together. One of the guy came to one of my shows. I was like super happy to see him. And then, there's a couple out in Michigan that met. Didn't know they both listened to the show. Found out later that they were both Mean Boys fans.
Oh, that's hilarious.
Yeah, so there have been a couple Mean Boys weddings, which is always like, yeah, it's weird. It's weird.
Yeah, I can't.
Sometimes you live in a kitchen and it's,
yeah. I can't find the actual post I was talking about, but it was from Poe Zombie, and they got married, him and his gal, and he had pictures from in front of a haunted house because that's where they took their engagement photos. And then he was like, that night, I also ripped my pants, got drunk and lost my keys, and my parents told my entire wedding that they conceived me at that haunted house.
Whoa.
Which is maybe the best thing I've ever heard.
That's pretty rad.
Yeah, that's awesome.
You got a spooky dick, dude.
Yeah. You let the world know my mom got fucked near Frankenstein.
And then she bolted.
Well, that's the end of the reunion, everybody.
Yeah, that's those are the two shows. That's enough.
Damn. We just ruined a perfectly spotless giraffe.
That happened again. I couldn't think of a
wait, what?
I couldn't think of a joke.
What do you mean it happened again?
It happened in Nambia.
Another spotless giraffe was born?
Are you sure it wasn't the same story but a different like news? I'm not being a dick.
No, literally the headline was another spotless giraffe is born.
Damn.
In Nambia.
What a fucking biter.
Biter?
You bit the style of that first spotless giraffe.
Oh, yeah.
I'm like, how much are we polluting giraffe habitats that this is...
Yeah, I was like, that's fucking crazy. I mean, it's not a joke. It's just big news for if you hate spots.
Big news if you hate spots. Okay. I think that's the show, everybody.
Yeah, that's it. Grab your tickets for Halloween, October 20th in Hollywood, California. The link is in our bio. What is the voicemail? 804-818-MEAN.
Yep.
So leave us a voicemail, send us an email, send us an Instagram, send us whatever. Yeah, I think that's it, unless anybody's got anything to plug.
Nope. Love you guys. Watch my new stand-up special live in Tucson, now on YouTube. Hour of me doing comedy. Lots of fun.
It's good. It's very good. Everyone should watch it.
All right.
Fuck everything. God is dead. Oh, I'm sorry.